I'm Markel Harmes. I'm the CEO of Qlix. We've built a German search engine and a browser. It's a combined product. We do not store any data about our users. We also prevent everyone else from tracking you through the internet. We are a team of 100-ish people in Munich. We are financed by Hubert Burda Media, which is a big publisher in Europe, and Mozilla invested into us, the maker of Firefox. You shouldn't trust me, by the way. I think this is a scheme that came across today, because I could just be a sleazy presenter. You should actually check all the facts. This is why everything we do is open source, and I'll talk about this in a second. I'm not against data. Data is really, really important, and the last thing we want to achieve is a world without data, because it's a really terrible, awful world. I give you one example. We built a search engine. I'm sure Brian has the same problem. This is a typical query in Germany. It's red roses. And surprisingly, the best answer for this, and we actually find it, is a TV series. It's a famous German TV series. I think it airs once a week. It's called Red Roses. And you can actually pretty much easily learn this from crawling the web. Except if you crawl the web, you will make one terrible mistake, and that is on the 14th of July. 14th of February, I'm a bad husband, which is Valentine's Day. It's the one day where if people search for red roses, the TV series really doesn't count. Your first result has to be how to order red roses. Now, you cannot learn this from crawling. You can only learn this if you observe people what they do in a time frame. And this is why data is really, really, really important. And you cannot just say, let's not collect any data about people and what they do, because you will miserably fail if you want to build a search engine. This is the second half. Data is really, really, really bad, and no one should be allowed to collect it. People actually have a very good intuition about it. There was a Forza questionnaire. People were asked, do you trust the internet? Now, what you can see is 80% don't trust the internet with their data. Now, people don't yet change because convenience and laziness and all the good reasons for that. But they really should, because they are right not to trust. And I want to give you a good example. I brought anonymous marketing data. So you can go to the market, to one of these exchanges, and say, look, I want to target a 20 to 30-year-old woman with a good household income because I want to market my new product to them. And what you get is completely, by the way, GDPR-compliant data back. I give you something of this. This is one of the data points you get back. It's something that a user has visited. Now, I blacked out something. It doesn't really matter. I have a second one. This is a German doctor. Anyone concerned with me showing that web page? Better? You should see the hammer coming. I have a third one. This is all, you can buy this for around 1 euro cent per thousand. So it's really cheap. Anyone concerned? You should really all raise your arm by now. But you obviously don't, because how should you know? This is a bank. There's a bank account number in there. It got into the data set by accident, but it happens more often than you would believe. Now, all three of these URLs, by definition, are actually not private. They are public. You can find them in the search index. It's really not a problem. But conveniently, the market exchanges give you one more data point. And that's one person has visited all these three domains. Now you've learned quite a bit. You learn that someone is visiting the fitness profile of Little Vegan, maybe Little Vegan, her or himself. That person has access to the administrator account of this doctor and an account at a local bank in Munich. With these three data points and any search engine, FindX, Qlix, Google, Bing, you'll find out it's her. It's just three data points. Whenever I have these data sets, usually it takes 3 to 9 URLs and you have any person identified. There are organizations who have significantly more than just 3 URLs. We did a large study in Germany seeing who monitors what of the internet traffic. So you find Google has around 60%, Facebook 23%. This is 2 years old. Facebook in about hours by 40%. Just to make this number clear, because very often you hear, well, then don't use Google if you don't like them. Don't log in into Facebook. This is if you don't use their services. So if today you're annoyed, you destroy your Android phone. You remove Chrome from your computer. You never watch a YouTube video again. And you never do a Google search. If you do all these steps, you've actively opted out and made your life very miserable. If you do all this, they will see 6 out of 10 things that you do in the internet. If you never had a Facebook account, they know 2 to 4 out of 10 things you do in the internet. You've never opted into that. This is why it's so important that you install Better or that you install something like Clix, because we stop this. Now, again, you might say, I have nothing to hide, and we heard this example in the morning. Maybe you even don't mind a microphone on the toilet. But it's not as simple. I'm, for example, having a cold today, and I have no problem sharing it. If my voice goes down, I'm sorry for having a cold. I might have a problem, however, sharing with all of you that I've done an HIV test this morning. There's a good reason why we don't communicate by coming on stage and saying, guys, I'm really excited being here. I did an HIV test this morning. It's usually up to me to decide whether I share this information or not, except if I use the internet. If I inform myself about an HIV test at Mayo Clinic, you'll find all this information. This is Clix blocking. All these companies are spying on me and storing this data. And there are companies like, for example, BlueKai. They now belong to Oracle. Their business model is selling profiles. You can go there and ask for profiles of people who did an HIV test. This is not okay. Now, even if you've never had any sickness or you don't mind sharing it, all of us have a bank account, at least most of us. Most banks actually have trackers when you're logged in. This is logged in into HSBC, and you see trackers getting this information. Now, I've never opted into that, and actually, I believe most of the banks don't know it. But the way the infrastructure today is built is people use frameworks to build apps, to build websites, and they come pre-packaged with all this shit. And it means basically all my private information is just public, and I can go actually to a market exchange and buy all this data. And it's incredibly cheap. Don't get me even started once you logged into something, because then they actually have all your data. So if you use Google while being logged in, or if you log into Facebook, they literally have everything. And it doesn't stop there. That's the ultimate problem. The complete ecosystem is built on hundreds of companies exchanging all this data. So even if you trust actually Google and Facebook, which probably have the best security engineers in the world, the business model is that all these tiny companies exchange all the information. And you just need to find the weakest link, the one guy on that small island without GDPR who's going to sell you that data. And there's always a weakest link. Even if you trust companies, you really shouldn't. Really not. Because all data, this is Mark's law of data, my law of data, all data that gets collected eventually becomes public. Even if the company is the most trustworthy company in the world, and I know there's a lot of Google bashing, I actually think it's not a really bad company. But you have to trust them forever, and you have to trust each and every individual in that company. Now, MySpace used to be a huge company. It used to be the Google of the times. Anyone remembering MySpace? I think they're bankrupt or sold or something. I don't even know. Yahoo just got sold. And whenever a company gets sold, all your data got sold. So this is the example of BlueKai with their 700 million profiles, like the HIV example. They got acquired by Oracle. Now, Oracle might decide to just change the privacy policy. The data will never be deleted. You just need one unethical employee, and all your privacy protection is gone. You just need one hacker going into the data and stealing it, and all your data is gone. Now, I said we need data because the internet as we know it will fall apart if we don't have data. We believe in privacy by design. We call it human web. Actually, with Clix, we collect a hell lot of data, and Red Roses is a very good example for that. However, you shouldn't trust us. We strictly distinguish between what's on your device and what reaches the Clix server. There's actually third-party proxies between us and the users. All the code is open source, and the rule is, the moment the data reaches our technology, our backend, in principle, it should be possible to make that data public, and none of our users should be in danger. So it's much more than just taking out an IP address like the GDPR ask or not having a unique identifier for a user. It is, for example, not having linkage between two subsequent actions that a user does. This is really important. And this is our internal mantra. If one of our employees would turn really evil, or if someone decided to hack our computer, it would be bad, and we wouldn't be happy about it. But we are relatively certain none of our users would ever be in danger. I say relatively certain. There is no 100% privacy certainty in technology. There never is. But to the best of our knowledge and all the penetration tests that we do, it is safe. We're at the beginning of the industry. Every industry that starts is really ugly, dirty, and shitty because growth is money in the beginning. We are only 20-some years old with the internet. The iPhone is just 10 years old. We are babies in that perspective. And it's our job to change this picture to what Europe looks today. We wouldn't accept coal mines and industry looking like this in Europe. And we shouldn't accept this happening for data. I can't promise when this will happen, but I'm absolutely sure eventually the customers will stand up and fight against this. Thanks a lot.